So in this video, I'm going to talk about the importance of physical activity and exercise. I'm going to address the difference between those two and why you need both to lead a healthy lifestyle. See this clip here where me and my daughter are sweeping the floor. Am I exercising or being physically active?
See, we exercise all the time.
We exercise all the time.
Are you serious?
Unfortunately, some people get confused like how me and my daughter were confused. Let's understand this further. Physical activity is any type of movement that requires a little bit of energy expenditure, that probably requires a little bit of strength. For example, let us say I'm picking up something from the floor here. So that requires a certain amount of muscle contraction and energy expenditure. So that's what I call as a physically active. So when I say exercise, I'm doing the same movement that requires an energy expenditure, probably a little bit more energy expenditure, but I'm going to maintain that for a certain amount of period. And that period could be anywhere between 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, or so on. So when we define the intensity, we use a sitting as an example. So let us say you're still spending a certain amount of energy while you're sitting, right? A physically active movement could be around like 2 to 3 times of the energy expenditure during sitting. So let us say, for example, I'm sweeping the floor here. So that's probably around like 1.5 to 2 times the energy expenditure that happens during sitting. So let us say I want to exercise. So I want to at least aim for more than 4 times the energy expenditure during sitting. So let us say, example, that I'm doing a skipping rope. So that's like, if I maintain this period for around like 5 to 10 minutes or so, that's an exercise. I'm probably expenditure around like maybe 4 to 5 times of my sitting time. So let us say I'm dancing, right? So I'm dancing. So this again, if I do this for a period of 5 to 10 minutes, that counts as an exercise. So we know from studies that being physically inactive is equally dangerous when compared to lacking regular physical exercise. So studies have shown that if you take a physically inactive person and you make them a physically active, so basically the good way to think about is like decrease their sitting time to less than 4 hours per day total, okay? So if you do that, the risk of all-cause mortality decreases by 20%. So what exactly is this all-cause mortality? So let us say, example, that you have, let's say you have a diabetes, okay? So the diabetes increases risk for heart disease, and the heart disease causes a heart attack, and then patient dies. So you know that if you're physically active, you could have prevented diabetes, which in turn could have prevented heart disease, which in turn could have prevented heart attack. So let us say you are weak by not being physically active, and then because you're weak, you fell down. Let us say this is a patient of like 65 years old. And let's say this patient was physically inactive, which means that her bone health was probably not in a good shape. So then she has a fracture, and that fracture relates to disability. And this disability relates to a clot in the lung that results in death. Again, this all stems to physically inactivity. You see how physical inactivity could be the basis of everything. And that's what we call as an all-cause mortality, like mortality or death from all causes, just being physically active decreases the risk by 20%. You can lower the risk of death from all causes by almost 30 to 40% if you start exercising regularly, at least 20 to 30 minutes a day. So start exercising today, don't postpone exercise. I have a number of videos on my channel to get you started on this exercise journey. And I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.